How's it going, everybody? Peter here, and a warm welcome to another Let's Play of Train Sim World 4. Well, folks, this is a video I've just inserted into the schedule, as I didn't really intend getting this cargo pack, of which is the TEA tankers, in the VTG branding liveries, and you do get a set of four different colours, and the one in this scenario will be the blue ones, as they are used on the Kingsbury to Humber and Lindsay oil duties. And I do have a non-narrated Let's Play to come after this one, of which will be of the green tankers, so that will be an extra video. So what we'll do before we set off, we'll have a nosy at the tank cars themselves, and we'll see what this pack is all about. I did get this one for a discount, as I do have the Great Western Express and the Midland Mainline installed already. Although, to be honest, I would have liked it better if there were a Class 60 included in this pack, but we'll have to make do with a Class 66. And I will say this, and you will find out in 2024 when that video goes live, I did do the 6E57, of which was coming from Nottingham to Derby. And I will tell you this, the loaded tankers, it's a very hard experience, and you'll see what I mean. However, on this occasion, we will be heading towards Nottingham, so it won't be as hard as our train is unloaded. So, without further ado, let's jump in and let's go into external view and we'll have a quick look around the train before we set off, as we don't want to disrupt any of the traffic too much. So, we'll have a nosy outside, then I'll set up the cab and we'll get going then. Okay, so these are the blue versions, and you do get green, red, and grey versions, and I do believe the latter two, the red and grey ones, are used on the Great Western Express. So, just want to show you that quickly. And what we will do, we've got 24, as it would be very difficult for a Class 66 to pull 30 tank cars, unlike the Class 60, as there is some videos on my channel from 2017 of which can be seen where a Class 60 can pull up to 32. So our traction today, folks, is 66127. So without further ado, let's jump back into the cab and let's get going then. Actually, just one wee moment, I'm going to get the thumbnail done and then we will get stuck in and proceed onwards to Nottingham. So I'll just get this done first and then we can get stuck in and do a straight run to Nottingham. Okay, so we've got a lighter train as our tank cars are empty. However, if you do the return journey with a loaded tank train, it will be much harder. And I would recommend braking for any red signals at about 2 miles to go and try and get your speed down to about 20 miles an hour before, well, after passing the final approach signal, as that should bring you down to stop short of the red signal without failing the mission. So I just want to share that out there for those that may be having problems with handling such a very heavy freight train like. Okay. As I said, folks, we do get a Class 66 included with this pack, but it's nothing new, so I'm not really going to go into the ins and the outs, apart from I've just turned on the Vigilance system, just to give us maximum points for this scenario-like, but had this been a Class 60, a brand new heavy-hull diesel locomotive, of which I was hoping that would be available for train simulator, progression trains in World 4, as I like to try new trains and that. Had this been a Class 60, I would have gone through more of the locomotive, but to be honest, in terms of the Class 66, we've been there, seen it, done that, got the medal, and that's all there is for it. There's really nothing new in terms of the locomotive, as I've covered it many times before in past Let's Plays and that, so nothing new, folks, so we'll skip that and just focus on the scenario itself. So folks, that brings us up to the next question that some of you may ask me in the comments. Would I recommend getting this tanker pack? Well, that's not for me to judge or to make that decision for you. It's really down to you and what you feel is good value or not. Personally, I used to see these tank cars quite a lot on the railway network, mostly the Class 60s, when I used to live in England. So, in truth, it's really up to you, but this brings back nostalgia for me, so that's why I took the plunge and bought the pack. And because I already own this route and the Great Western Express, that's why I got some discount. And there's about one fifth off the price of what it would be as a standalone. So if you do own the Great Western Express and the Midland Mainline, the price is more attractive if you go for the bundle deal. But personally, I think these freight cars are really, really nice, and they are well made. And just to clear up anything, no, these are not reskins of the older Trans-Pennine freight pack that comes with a Class 40. These are not the same models at all. These are brand new models made by Skyhook Games, who also creates this route as well. So I'm hoping that in the future, perhaps Skyhook Games or Just Trains may do a Class 60 pack, if not Dovetail Games themselves, as the Class 60 they did Train Simulator Classic. It's a very nice 3D model, and with a bit of work, that could qualify as a base model, as long as it's enhanced. But personally, I would like to see a brand new Class 60 pack produced by either Just Trains or Skyhook Games, as I do feel strongly that if Skyhook Games did a Class 60 pack, they could do a freight bundle with these tank cars, and you'd have the complete train, and it would be really fun to thrash a Class 60 on the Midland Main Line between Derby and Nottingham, of which we're doing here, folks. And we do have a maximum permitted speed limit for our train of 60 miles an hour. So folks, it's entirely down to you if you decide to get this freight car pack or not. It's really up to you. Initially, I was going to hold off for a Steam sale because I did find the price of £10 a wee bit expensive, but because I've got a 20%, well, almost 20% discount, it's actually 19% discount at the time I purchased this pack, the price was more attractive. So I said to myself, go ahead, give it a try, do a let's play, and let the viewers make their own judgments and decisions on this pack. So if you like this kind of thing, go for it, but it's down to you. Anyway folks, coming up to 50 miles an hour, I will ease off the throttle. I'm only using notch 2, and I think we're increasing our speed because we are going downhill towards Nottingham from Derby. And in truth, this will be a lot easier compared to the return journey that you're going to see in 2024 in the schedule. So stay tuned for that one, as I do have a lot more planned Let's Plays of Train Sim World 4 coming in the new year. Okay, I just thought I'd mention something else about the Class 66 itself. Now, I'm neutral with the Class 66, but it would have been grand if the DB large logo cargo liveried Class 66 was included with this, as that would be a present day modern livery to use with these cool looking tank cars. So that's just my constructive feedback that I give for this freight car pack. And I think if the DB red large logo liveried Class 66 had been done, that would bring it well in line with this pack. But I'm certain that someone may well do that livery for this Class 66 just to bring it up to present day operations. So I will keep a lookout on the community hub, and when I do future Let's Plays for this train, I will try other liveries just to spice things up a bit on my 2024 Let's Plays. Okay. Anyway, folks, we've got a haze in the sky. So we've got haze ahead of us, and it's quite difficult to see. So I'm going to turn on my wipers, and what I'm going to do, so I can concentrate on the line ahead, I will talk to you more when we get to Nottingham. So I'll chat to you more when we get towards Nottingham, okay? Okay, I've noticed one thing about this Class 66. Those wipers do clunk a bit, don't they? And another thing as well, I'm just proceeding at a very cautious speed ahead, as I don't want to run that red signal up ahead and potentially fail the mission. So I'm just being cautious here, folks, okay? But once I get the go ahead, I will open up the bar, as we're not anywhere near Nottingham just yet. That's about 5 or so miles away. Thank you. Okay, that's grand. We've got the road, so we can proceed with caution. And I'll just put the power back on. In fact, scratch that. I'll just coast here for a wee bit as we're just coming over a junction that is 15 miles an hour up ahead. Okay, so it's about 7 miles back there. It was not 5 miles, so we've got 6.1 to go. And we've got some very adverse weather ahead of us, and I'm keeping the wipers on to at least try and improve my vision ahead of the tracks, as I've not really played this route too much. And I do have more let's plays of the Midland Mainline to come, as I don't think I've done this one this year, as I did say I was going to do a lot more of Train Sim World 4 in 2024. So this is kind of what to expect in the new year when our let's plays switch over from Train Sim World 3 into Train Sim World 4. So we have got a top speed limit for our train of 60 miles an hour, but I'm just driving with diligence here, so I don't run any red signals, as being unable to see much down the track ahead, I don't think I would be able to stop in time, and it's more likely that a red signal will catch me off guard if I'm not too careful on this one. But the weather is completely random. It is dynamic weather, so the game picks the weather for me, so I have no control over it, but I think you can change that in the settings if you want to, as this is timetable mode. Thank you. Okay, folks, we're just getting closer to Nottingham now, so I'm going to idle the car, and we will have to stop for a signal check just outside Nottingham station. And I quite enjoyed this one, and this is based around 2017, so there is room for a Class 60 pack to come out in the future, and I really do hope that will materialise. And personally, I definitely do like this freight pack from Skyhook Games, so well done to them for bringing out this wagon pack. As I said, folks, if you have the Great Western Express and this Midland Mainline route already, you will get some discount if you go for the bundle deal, so take advantage of those. But personally, I'm glad I took the plunge and I did buy this one, as I did get some discount, and I really am enjoying myself. Anyways, just slowing down for this upcoming signal. It should clear as we get closer to it, but I like to be ready so I can stop, as I can't see a thing in front of me, so I will have to kind of tiptoe into Nottingham so that I don't run any red signals and stuff, you know. Anyways, that's just cleared to a green, so we're grand to go and try and get the brakes off so we can continue moving into Nottingham station, and that will be our finishing point for this scenario. Yes, folks, I will be honest with you. I'm not used to the brakes on this Class 66. And we do have an upcoming speed limit of 15 miles an hour, so I'm not going to go too fast as I can't see very far ahead. But anyways, we are coming into Nottingham Station now, and that concludes this Let's Play. Please do feel free to let me know your thoughts in the comment section below if you want to, and if you're still with me through to the end of this Let's Play, big thank you for staying with me. I appreciate your support, and I appreciate you taking the time to watch my Let's Plays of these train simulator games, and I do hope you have enjoyed it, and I'm sure most of you do. But till next time, folks, I just want to say to you, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, take care, and I will see you in the next one.